Hi, friends of the planet, Miro here. Today, I'm so thrilled to have with us Mike Stanton, who's the new CEO of the National Auto Dealers Association. So Mike, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us this morning.
Oh, thanks for having me.
And so we are so excited to have you here because there's a lot of talk about transportation and what the future of cars will look like and what that means for Americans. So we have some questions and you're here to answer them. So this is a really perfect time to have this conversation. I wanted to dive in and ask, you know, as we're having a national conversation about the future of transportation and about electric vehicles and autonomous vehicle technology, how is your membership feeling about this change? Are they apprehensive or are they welcoming of the change? Are they looking forward to opportunities that may exist as, you know, a lot of this new technology becomes deployed?
So I can speak with some authority because since coming into this job about 4 months ago, I have literally talked to hundreds of dealers. And so I can say with certainty that dealers are very excited about selling electric vehicles. And proof of that is they're starting to make the investments. Some of them already have, some are in the process. And these are big investments for dealers. Like individually speaking, we're talking about several hundreds of thousands of dollars to install charging stations, to train their employees, both from a product perspective, but also a safety perspective. And these batteries are super heavy and you got to have a safe place to store them. And you also have to have the facility to store them. So they're upgrading that as well. It's an exciting time to prepare for what's coming. And there's a lot coming. There's about 17, 18 models currently out there that dealers are selling, but by next year, it's going to be 34. And then the numbers just continue to ramp up. And, you know, dealers are, they're in the car business. They love cars. They also love customers. And that's what they do, both new product and taking care of customers. And like I said at the beginning, they couldn't be more excited.
That's great. I was also just curious to ask, as more states and automakers come out with plans to phase out the sales of internal combustion engines within the next decade or so, the goals are predicted to have a massive uptick in sales of electric vehicles, but a lot of Americans are still unsure about them. What role will these dealerships play in convincing Americans to switch to electric vehicles?
Well, as I mentioned before, the product, I mean, you've got to see it and not necessarily just see it online or see what's coming. To actually experience the product, I think that's when you'll see the mass market get really excited about this. Currently, you know, consumers have got some worries and some concerns, but it's really just through a lack of education, and dealers will be there to provide that. I mean, you think about it, there's just not that many in the market right now. And it's not like we're all in the market all the time to buy a car. You only do that every so often, unless you've got lots and lots of money. So they're not readily available to the mass market today. And what we've heard from consumers, and these things can all be overcome, and because the product's getting better, is they're asking questions like, well, how am I going to charge this? How is that going to work? How far is the battery going to last in terms of that charge? But also, is the battery itself going to last? Like the iPhone, the battery will deteriorate over time. So we've got to overcome that. And we'll do that through, you know, asking the right questions and having that dialogue, that face-to-face dialogue to address the consumer's questions. And then we'll be schooled up through some education that we're doing here at NADA and with our car company partners to make sure that we're asking the right questions and we're providing the right answers. So there's still some things that we need to overcome, certainly, but the trend is looking good. I mean, when you think about, you know, we live here in DC, there are a lot of folks that are in apartments or condos, or I live in the city and have off-street parking. It's how am I going to get to that actual outlet and make sure that I can plug in the vehicle? So there's just a lot to overcome. But as I mentioned before, dealers are excited about the opportunity to help educate the customers.
So to follow up on that point, right now, Tesla is the star of the US EV market, but they're also, for the most part, a luxury vehicle that's not accessible to a lot of people. And, you know, I think when people think of Tesla, they think of a luxury sedan. But as automakers are rolling out more models, you know, what are your thoughts about the types of models that will get Americans to begin envisioning themselves driving it? Is it going to be the introduction of more trucks, small sedans, crossovers? Like, what are the early models that can really get Americans thinking, like, yeah, I can drive that. That's not just a luxury sedan. That fits into my lifestyle.
I really agree with the question. I'll try and add some color commentary. But yeah. I think you're absolutely right. You know, when I see a Tesla, I think when most consumers see a Tesla, they don't see an EV per se. They see this luxury vehicle. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I just think that's how the market views Tesla owners right now. They often represent maybe a second or third vehicle that consumers buy, and they can be considered a status symbol as well. And like you said, though, we need to get EVs out to the mass market, and we need to do that by making them more affordable. I mentioned anxiety range. We've got to address that, and our manufacturers are doing that, and really more appealing from a lifestyle perspective. Because most of us can't afford a second or a third car. You need a primary driver that's going to address your needs. And I don't know if you all know this, trucks and SUVs are now 75% of the market. Yeah. I mean, the sedan market is significant, but it is shrinking. Customers need trucks sometimes for work. They need SUVs to take their kids to and from wherever, or their stuff. People buy vehicles to fit their lifestyle needs. And as more and more EVs come to market that will address the lifestyle need, then they'll be much more, I think, appealing, and people will be ready to buy them. You know, assuming they're affordable too. And that's something that we're working on here at NADA, working with the government and trying to make sure that the proper incentives are in place to help support the administration's goals.
I know that some electric vehicle startups want to sell directly to consumers and they want to bypass franchise dealerships altogether. Should they be allowed to do this? And I'm curious to know your opinion as to why or why not. And I would love it if you could explain why dealerships might be a critical component of the car buying process.
You know, some relatively new and some very new manufacturers are going to market by selling direct to consumers, and that's bypassing the franchised dealer network. But these sales have been geared, as we talked about before, exclusively to the higher end of the market. And if we're trying to address the mass market, which I know that's what the ultimate goal is in reading with the Biden administration and engaging with some of those lawmakers, that's the plan. And for us to be able to roll all of this out in a mass market way, the dealers are essential. Really, I don't see how you could do it without the dealers. You think about just the numbers. There are 17,000 dealerships out there that have made the investments that I've talked about before. They're the ones that are going to be able to meet face-to-face and answer consumer questions, again, about other things that we've talked about. So, but when, the other thing that I don't think the average consumer thinks about, there's something called intra-brand competition. So there's competition, and the car market is competitive like many of the markets here or industries here in the US. But we've got dealers with the same brand. So pick a Honda or a Hyundai or a Toyota. They are competing against their like brand dealerships for the customer's business. And that's got one very good effect for consumers. You get a better customer experience and you get a better price. I mean, that is just a much better situation. And we have the data. Consumers save money when they shop. It's just the way it is. So I don't know how a model that's vertically integrated, essentially a monopoly. I mean, you go to one of these direct sellers, you've got one place to buy a vehicle and you're buying that vehicle at the price it's stated. There's no room for negotiation there. And we don't think that that's the model that serves customers as well as the model that our franchise dealers represent. And you know, this is such a big purchase. It's second for most to a home. And we find that there are very few people buying a home online. Customers that are spending this kind of money, they want to experience, especially a new technology. They want to be able to drive it. They want to be able to talk to people in the know about it. And that's our franchise dealers. And then when there's a problem, you know, hopefully there's no problems, but eventually these vehicles are going to have, you know, you need maintenance work or there's going to be questions. The idea of going in and talking to somebody is very appealing versus getting on one of these 1-800 mazes and trying to navigate your way to find out the answer to your question or to a real problem. I mean, you could be stuck on the side of the road, God forbid, with a problem and being on hold, wandering through that 800 maze versus the tried and true franchise dealer that's been there, done that, can quickly get out there and get consumers the help that they need. So we're well positioned to do that from a number of perspectives.
I also think that, you know, Americans have such a connection to their dealership and they're often repeat customers. I grew up in a small town and Bob Noble Chevrolet sponsored our youth soccer league and Pop Warner. So I think, you know, that's kind of an important component for a lot of American consumers as they're buying their cars.
We hear that a lot. We hear about the charitable contributions that dealers make and the importance that they have in their pillars in their community, but they also provide a lot of really good jobs. I mean, jobs you don't have to go to college for, and you can go right up the chain and have a great career at an automobile dealership. So when we're talking to lawmakers, we talk about those great jobs and the sales tax, the income tax, just the contribution that franchise dealers have to the overall economy is really significant. And it's important because these are really good jobs.
Absolutely. And to follow up on that, how can people encourage their local dealerships to maybe start carrying more EV models? Do you have any advice for how consumers can make the nudge to see those cars being sold where they live?
Vehicles across our industry are in short supply right now.
Yeah.
There is no vehicle sitting on any manufacturer's yard or lot that is not sold. And the way it works is the dealers buy vehicles from the manufacturer, and then they turn around and they sell them to consumers. So right now we're just waiting on the product. Be it, you know, a gas engine, diesel engine, EV. And we've been waiting on EVs for quite some time because, quite frankly, we've been behind. Our manufacturers are playing catch up, but they're going to catch up in a big way. If you just look at what's coming, and the product looks really, really good, and it's going to be very appealing. So we just have to make sure as dealers that we're ready, that we're trained up, that we've made the investments in the right infrastructure that I mentioned before. As soon as it arrives, you know, the dealers are going to be right there promoting it and encouraging customers to try these new EVs. And then, as you all know, they're going to be encouraging customers to buy these EVs as well. So it's an exciting time for car dealers, an exciting time for consumers and for the industry overall, but we're still a little bit behind, or we're just kind of waiting for that wave to hit us. And we just want to make sure that we're prepared.
Well, I think a lot of consumers are going to be ready and hopefully anticipating that wave, and in partnership with their local dealers, you know, can make the purchasing decisions that are right for them. So thank you so much, Mike. That was really good information for us, for our readers. And we really appreciate you taking the time today.
No, I appreciate the opportunity. It was nice talking to you, Bob.
Thank you.